Welcome to PJP School. I'm Kristen Volin, a kindergarten teacher here.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Cameron, a registered early childhood educator here in kindergarten. Art is a great way for children to explore and create.
We are very excited to introduce the PJP School Arts Festival and welcome artist Shelby Smith from the Muse.
Hello, my name is Shelby Smith and I am the Art Center programmer at the Muse as well as an artist myself. In today's class, we're going to be looking at mark making. So what is mark making? Mark making is basically how you put the paint down, whether you use paintbrushes, whether you use your fingers, whether you use whatever you find in the recycling bin. There's lots of ways to make marks, and that's how an artist defines their signature style. So in today's workshop, we're going to be trying out some different mark making tools, as well as creating some of our own from craft materials and recycled materials around the house. So first, we're going to look at some paintbrushes. I brought a few different options here, and depending on the type of paintbrush that you're using, you're going to get different results. So this one here is a very smooth flat brush, great for painting backgrounds or smooth finishes. I also have this really old ratty brush, and I love old brushes because the marks that they make are very unique. And if you have an old brush that you really don't care for, you could even cut up the bristles to make unique marks. I've also got these two smaller brushes. This one's really stiff. It's great for flicking paint, so we'll be trying out some of that, and just a smaller flat brush. So let's get some paint. Oop! So here's just that smooth brush. And what I've done here is I've lined up red, yellow, and orange to create kind of a rainbow. And even with different brushes, you can do different things to get different results. So here I'm doing a fun zigzag. Up top I've done that. You can also just kind of dab it. So no matter what brush you're using, there's always different ways to use it and different marks you can create with it. All right, so here we've got that ratty brush, and as you can see, the bristles are a little more uneven, a little bit more natural in texture. So we're gonna try that with this paint here just to show a different type of mark. So as we can see here, I'm just doing that same straight line, but you're getting a lot more lines of different colors within the paint when you're mixing them together. And when I do the zigzag, it's a lot more wispy. So something like this is great if you want to paint maybe a furry little cat. You can do the fur really nice, or if you want to paint some grass. Nice fluffy clouds. So you can do all kinds of things with different paintbrushes. All right, so now we're going to try doing some flicking with a paintbrush as well as dabbing. This is a smaller circular brush, and it's great if you want to do little round daubles, little polka dots. And this one's a little messy, but luckily we're using tempera paints, so you can wash those fingers off nice and easy and wash your table if you get it everywhere. That's the great thing about tempera paints. You can make a mess and clean it up really easy. And the funnest part about doing art is making the mess, so you're just gonna take your finger, place it on top of the brush, point the brush where you want the paint to land, pull your finger back, and release. So you get nice, fine little sparkles. So if you were doing this on a black background, maybe with white paint, it's a great way to paint stars. It's also just a fun way to add some extra elements to your painting. Another way that you can flick the paint is to use a snap of the wrist. This one's a little bit harder to control, so if you're doing this, make sure you've got a nice area covered in paper, something you can easily clean. So all you're gonna do is load that paintbrush up with paint and flick your wrist at the end, and you're gonna wanna flick it again towards the paper. Otherwise, it can go anywhere. So you see with these, you get more of a long line of paint drips with sort of a concentration at the top where it hits. So
try some different colors. And it's that easy.
Beautiful. Look at those fun marks.
And then finally, we have the square brush here. This is just a normal flat brush. It's also got a bit more of a bristly texture to it. So you can see here, it's similar, or so you can see here, great for doing lines of equal distance. And again, if you're mixing multiple colors, you can see those in the different brush strokes there. That's my favorite thing, to put more than one color on the brush and not mix it. So usually you want to mix colors, but if you put more than one, then you get variation in the color within the one brush stroke. So try doing some squiggles. Try doing some zigzags. And try just even dapping. So see how you get those little tiny fuzzy bits? And you can just stipple that. So that's a good way maybe to make a little tree. Just a nice loose little tree there. But just have fun and try out using it in different ways. All right, so now let's move on to some less traditional tools. Here I've got some plastic cutlery. So these are also great mark-making tools. You can find them with your takeout food. You can even use your actual cutlery at home, because once again, tempera paint is very safe and washable. You can use other kitchen cutlery. You could use potato mashers, spatulas, egg beaters, all kinds of things. And you can just wash them right off. So it's a great place to explore. Ask your parents and get some stuff from the kitchen and have some fun. So we're going to try out these tools just to show you. So here we've got a nice little spoon. So what we can do is dip that into the paint, and you can dab it, and you get kind of a concentration right where the base of the spoon is there. You see where it sticks more paint. And they kind of look like little eggs or just little splatters. So you can try using the spoon. You can also try using it as a scraper, and you get kind of uneven touching. Next, let's try out that fork. So we'll use red for that. And the fork's a little different. You can get four little straight lines. So a fork, again, would be great for doing some grass. You can do little squiggles with them, but they don't hold paint too well. So one thing I like to do with the forks is to get the paint down with something else. So I'm just going to put some white paint down here. And then you can take that fork, so I've just put some white paint down here, and you can drag it through. And then you can have those red lines go a lot longer. So I use white because it doesn't affect the color that I'm using, but you could do that through green or red. So let's try with some yellow. We'll just put that all over. And I'm just spreading with a plastic knife here. This is a painting knife. So I'm just going to spread that out, and then we can take that fork, and we'll do a little bit of blue on this one, and you can just drag it right through that. Look at that. The other thing you can do with forks is, because they're like a little prong, you can just kind of print them. So just four pronged little prints.
You can also just use the tips to make four little dots. Or you could angle it and just use one for a dot. So there's lots of different ways you can use even the most simple components to make some really cool designs and art. All right, good on those ones, I think. Like that. Okay, so a few more things you can make just from tools around the house. Here are a couple of things I've made with just some pieces of cardboard from my recycling bin, some scissors, and some yarn. So this one here is gonna print some stripes. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my little pad here and I'm just gonna demo that. I'm just painting this on. You can also dip it right into your paint if you have enough. And when we press that down, we get little stripes where the yarn was. So that's how that one works. So if you want to try to make one like that yourself, all you need is a little piece of cardboard, and I just cut them pretty small. You can make them any size you want. What I did to get the stripes even was I cut little indents into the edge here. And you can put them as close together or as far apart as you want. I'm doing these ones pretty far apart. And what you're going to do is take your yarn and just put it through those little slots. And I wrapped mine about 2 times so I could get a nice thick stripe. You can do 3, you can do 2. So you do one on the back side, you're going to move over to the other one. 1, 2. And then again to the next one. 1, 2. And 1, 2. And then I'm just going to cut that little bit extra off. If you want, you can tie these pieces together or tuck them under or tape them down, but you could also just leave them. They shouldn't come apart in one use. So that's that. That's how you make this one here and how you make those little stripes. You could also do, this is one that I did with more of a random pattern, so you could just take that string and wrap it around a piece of cardboard, make whatever kind of pattern you want, and we'll do a little tester of this one here. So you only really need to get the paint on the string. You will get it on the cardboard too, but that's okay. And you don't want to do too thick because then you'll print everything, so just a nice thin coat. And we're going to press that one down. Voila! So those are a couple you can use with string and cardboard. I've also done up a couple where I've just cut patterns into cardboard. And these ones can be used more as a scraping device. So once again, I'm going to put a bunch of paint onto the canvas or onto the paper here. And spread it out. And then I'm going to take this one here. So it both is pulling the paint away where I put it down, but also dragging a thin coat of it. So you can have big, thick spots of paint with thin stripes, or you could just use it on its own. Use it to scrape wet paint you've left down and make all kinds of fun textures. So that's my thicker one here. I've just cut out little rectangles so I can make a nice, kind of almost looks like the side of a castle. This one here, it's a little narrower, so we'll give that one a shot too. We'll use red over here. So this one's going to be a little narrower. So there you just got nice little thin stripes. You can see there. We'll put a bit more down over here. And I'm just going to spread it out with the back. And this time we'll do a bit of a squiggle. Okay.
So similar, if you don't have a big paintbrush like the one I used before, you could just use a flat piece of cardboard, no cuts in it, just nice and straight, and you could load that up with different colors to make a smooth transition. So we'll get a fresh piece of paper to try that. So I'm going to load some colors along the edge of my cardboard here. And I'm just going to apply it directly onto the cardboard. You could also put it into a palette first or onto a plate and then grab it, but I'm just going to put it right on. And then I'm going to take that, put it paint first down, and just pull. So see, you're getting a similar effect to those really large paintbrushes, and you can do the same squiggle technique with it. You can also use it to scrape paint away and around. So if you put the paint directly on and just want to pull it around, we can get some different kinds of effects here. So just try different movements, try what feels natural. Don't be afraid of making a mess or ruining what you have there. So it's nice you can see the little kind of hairs of the cardboard, because cardboard is a paper material. You get these little lines, and it kind of looks like you've squeegeed the paint a bit. So those are some things you can do with cardboard, and it doesn't have to be cardboard like this. It could be cereal boxes, frozen pizza boxes, anything that's just a stiffer paper will do. And we'll move on to something else. So a couple more cardboard objects I found in my recycling bin. We probably all have a lot of these. Toilet paper rolls, paper towel rolls will also do. And really anything that's got this circle shape is great because it allows you to easily print a nice little circle, and you could use that as maybe the outline for the sun, or maybe you just want to make a nice little circle pattern, and you can just stamp those right around, and you get a perfect circle every time. So if you're not a great drawer, you can just find something that's circular. You could use the lid off of a container, you could use a tin can, just the rim of it, to get different sizes. I've also taken the yarn again and made something with the cardboard roll. So similar to the cardboard piece where we tucked it around, this one I've just covered, and you can basically roll it into your paint. Just gonna make a huge mess here. And then roll it along the paper. You can get some different marks it again. So another couple things you can do with stuff from your recycling bin. All right, so now let's get to making our own paintbrushes. So in your kit, you should find a clothespin and some other items, some pom-poms, some feathers, some string. So this is a really easy way to make your own paintbrush. You just take the thing you have and you just grab something and pin it on, just like this little pom-pom here. And then you can start using that like a little paintbrush. So we can dab it, make nice little sunbursts. These also look like they could be the center of some nice flowers. You can also drag it. Oh, nope, we can't drag it. Got to get a better hold. And you can also drag it like a paintbrush. Just don't drag too hard because it might come off. I've got another pom-pom here. This one's got some longer sparkly hair, so we'll give that one a try too and see if we get some different effects. Ooh. Oh yeah, look at that. So we've got a little bit more of a spiky little hairy ball. So we can put those around.
Once again, we can use it and paint along with it. So there's a couple just with pom-poms there. Now, if you have some feathers, we can also use the feather to make a little paintbrush. This one's going to be a little bit finer to use. So it's a lot less heavy than the pom-pom. So we'll get some nice wispy feather marks. Oh, might need a little more paint on that. Let's see. Nice and smooth. And you can also just kind of dip the tips and brush light feathery strokes with your feather. They've also got a good little flick to them, but a little harder to control than a paintbrush. Finally, the most similar to a paintbrush here, I've taken some yarn and made it into some little bristles. So I'll show you how I do that. I'll show you how I do that really quick. So what you're gonna do is take some of that yarn, take three or four of your fingers and just start wrapping it around. And then, once you've done that a couple times, you're gonna take scissors very carefully. Get mom or dad to help you with this and just cut them. Once they're cut, you're gonna fold it in half. And tuck that into your pin. So from there, if you want, you can give your paintbrush a little haircut. Make sure he's nice and even. And then good to go. You can dip that in some paint. Need some different paint. So the yarn is a little bit more floppy than a paintbrush, but still definitely some nice fun marks you can make. You can see them here in purple. Just dragging it along. You can dab it a bit. Just really trying to do whatever you can with what you have to make different types of marks. And I'll just show you a couple examples of some other things I found around my craft room. So I found a little old silk flower, so that's another option for a paintbrush here. We'll dip that in. And this one's really just good for dabbing. So depending what stuff you have at home, maybe you have some old silk flowers, maybe you have some toys that you don't use anymore or that are easy to clean up, you can try those out. And another one here I've got is just this little balloon. So you should have a balloon in your kit. So just take that little balloon, and this is a good for making, again, smooth little circular dots. All right, so we'll get into the last little grouping of items I've found, some of them that you have in your bag, some of them that you might be able to steal from home, or some that you may be able to borrow from home. So balloon, this one's blown up a little bit bigger, and that's because we're going to make some bigger circles. So what I like to do with the balloon is pick a couple colors. I'm going to go with blue and orange. And you can see kind of what I've done here. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of mix them up a little bit. And then once you got a little puddle of paint there, what you're going to do is just take your balloon and press right into it. And you can twist it a little bit if you want. And then you get perfect little circles of swirling paint colors with some nice little pulling marks there. So you could try this with your favorite colors. You'll also find some Q-tips, and these are great for just making little dots. So I'm gonna just put some little dots around this one here, and they're perfect little circles.
You can also just take them and drag them. They work kind of more like a marker or something like that than a paintbrush because they're pretty solid, but you can still take the paint and make some designs with them that way. But I find if you're ever looking to do small little circles, these are the way to go. If you want to make little polka dots on someone's t-shirt, grab something small and round like a Q-tip or the eraser on the back of your pencil, and you can make those marks. And then finally, a couple things I've raided from both my kitchen and bathroom. So I've got just a big scrub brush here. I've got a little dish sponge here, and I've got a comb. So the comb's gonna work similar to the fork. These ones are gonna have their own ways of working too. So we'll start off with this scrub brush here. So I'm just gonna take that and dip it in my paint. And because these bristles are so stiff and coarse, get some nice wispy. Very good for going very straight with the lines, but not good at full coverage. So you're gonna get lots of wispy little lines. So if you wanna make a nice texture to paint on, this is a great way to do it. You can also take the back of this guy and kind of scrape with it. So depending what you have, there's lots of different ways to use it. But I encourage you to go take a look in your kitchen, your bathroom, whatever you got, and give it a try. Next, we got this little sponge guy. And this one, similarly, it's going to be best for just kind of pressing it down and to get some textures here. You can also take it and just scrape it along. And finally, our comb. So this will work similar either to the cardboard or to the forks that you've used, in that it's going to make a bunch of little lines. So they don't go very far again. So what you want to do is put down some paint first. And then you can run that comb right through there. Or you can use it to scrape away paint from other areas. Going straight, going back and forth. All right, so thank you for joining me. I hope you had fun trying out some different things to use as painting tools, and I hope you come up with some that I didn't even think of. Go around your kitchen, go around your bathroom, find some fun stuff. Make sure you ask mom and dad's permission first and have some fun and make some art.
I'm Amy Favreau. I'm a kindergarten teacher here at Pope John Paul II School. And we want to thank Shelby Smith for leading us today in all of our creative art exploration.
Hi, I'm Tiffany Penkoff, registered early childhood educator here at Pope John Paul II School, and I would love to thank the families for joining us today. If you would like any more information, please check out our Facebook page or give our school a call. Thank you.
All right, welcome everybody to our virtual jam. Happy to have you here. We're gonna start things off with one of my favorite artists and a message that I think we all need a little bit more of right now. Two, three.
Thing. Every little thing is gonna be alright. Singing, don't worry about a thing. Every little thing is gonna be alright. Rise up this morning, rise with the rising sun. Three little birds which by my doorstep singing sweet songs melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. Singing, don't worry about a thing.
Applauding right now. So if you don't know us, my name is Mr. Harty. To my right is Mr. Dunford, and that is Mr. Yura. So you're going to see a lot of different instruments being played today. I'm starting things off on the guitar. Mr. Dunford is playing the djembe. And the djembe is an African instrument from West Africa. And actually what's kind of cool is that the djembe translates to a circle of peace, which is definitely the message we're trying to send out today. And in the back with Mr. Yura, he's holding things down on the bass guitar. So our next tune that we're going to be playing for you is, I have a 1.5-year-old at home, and this artist is probably one of his favorite artists. His name's Raffi. And Raffi is an artist that I grew up on, and now it's kind of cool to see my little guy grow up on him as well too. So enjoy. 2, 3.
Biscuits in the oven, gonna wash them rise. Biscuits in the oven, gonna wash them rise. Biscuits in the oven, gonna wash them rise. Right before my very eyes, hey.
So this next song that we're gonna play for you today is about a cat. Now this cat wasn't the nicest cat in the whole world. In fact, the man who owned this cat tried getting rid of this cat every single which way he could. Now, I don't know if you know what kind of cat I'm talking about, but we're gonna tell you about it. So we're gonna start things off with the chorus. And if you know the chorus, I'd like you to sing along. The cat came back the very next day. The cat came back, I thought it was a goner, but the cat came back, he just wouldn't stay away. Old Mr. Johnson had some troubles of his own. He had a yellow cat which wouldn't leave him alone. He tried and he tried to give the cat away. He gave it to a man going far away. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back, they thought he was a goner. But the cat came back, he just couldn't stay away. The man around the corner swore he'd kill the cat on sight. He loaded up a shotgun with nails and dynamite. He waited and he waited for the cat to come around, but 97 pieces of the man that they found. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back, they thought he was a goner. But the cat came back, he just couldn't stay away. He gave it to a man going up in a balloon. He told him just to take it to the man in the moon. The balloon came down about 90 miles away, and where it is now I dare not say. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back, they thought it was a goner. But the cat came back, it just couldn't stay away. He gave it to a man going way out west. Told him just to take it to the one he loved best. First the train hit a curve and then it jumped the rail. Not a soul was left around to tell that gruesome tale. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back, they thought it was a goner. But the cat came back, it just couldn't stay away. Now the cat was the possessor of a family of his own, with 7 little kittens that came a cyclone. It tore the houses all apart and tossed the cat around. The air was filled with kittens, but no one was ever found. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back, they thought it was a goner. But the cat came back, it just couldn't stay away. Oh, hit the road, cat. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, cat. Don't you come back no more. Yeah, hit the road, cat. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, cat. Don't you come back no more. So this next tune that we're going to be playing for you is a really, really popular tune from a Disney Pixar movie. And like I said, with my one-year-old running around at home, I'm getting all caught up to date with my Disney flicks. So this one came up and it's a great tune. Hope you enjoy it.
You got a friend in me. When the road looks
rough ahead, and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed. You just remember what your old pal said, boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got troubles, I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We'll stick together, we can see it through, boy. You got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy. 1, 2, 3. As the years go by, friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's a destiny, boy. You got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me.
You guys are a fantastic audience. Thank you so much for listening and joining us today. So we're going to mix things up a little bit, and let's please give a warm round of applause for my partner, Mr. Dunford, who's going to come up and sing a couple tunes for you.
Thank you. So for this one here, Mr. Harty is going to play a wooden box. It's a wooden box over here. And inside that wooden box is just about everything you need for a drum kit. And the song I'm going to play is a Benny King song. I played at my wedding, so this goes out to Grace.
When the night has come and the land is dark, we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Whoa, stand by me.
with you.
All right, thank you so much. So we're gonna play this next tune, and one thing that we wanted to kind of show off in here was our baby grand piano. Now, I know a lot of you have probably seen an upright piano and what an upright piano looks like, but with this baby grand, how they used to be able to control volume is with the lid. Now, for our case, just because we wanted to look kind of flashy, is this is something called full stick. Full stick means that the lid is up as high as it can go. But if we wanted it a little bit softer, I can drop this down and totally close this all the way. But for today's purposes, just because we want to look nice and flashy, we're going to keep it nice and open for you. All right. So this next tune is a Beatles song, and Mr. Dunford's going to take it away on vocals.
Yeah, you'll probably recognize this one. Classic Beatles tune. Go ahead, Harty. When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be, let it be.
Thank you very much. Thank you for indulging me in my piano playing too. It's been a long time since I've got to dust off the keys. That was great. So we got one more tune for you. Another Beatles song because, you know, you can never get enough Beatles. And this last song, well, we saved it for last because especially with everything that's going on right now, this is kind of an important message that we want to get out to everyone. So no matter what's happening, we know that we can always rely on our friends to be there for us. Three.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you get up and walk out on me? Lend me your ear and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I just try with a little help from my friends. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. What do I do when my love is away? Does it worry to be alone? How do I feel at the end of the day? Why don't you ask me where I am? Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I just try with a little help from my friends. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. Could it be anybody? Oh, I said I need somebody to love. Should it be anybody? Oh, I said I need somebody to love. Yes, I'm certain it happens all the time. What do I see when I turn out those lights? I don't know, but I know it's mine. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I just try with a little help from my friends. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. Thank you very much. You guys have been a fantastic audience. I'm Mr. Harty, that's Mr. Dunford on drums, and Mr. Ural on bass. Have a great day, and we will see you next time. Take care, everybody.
Thank you.